So it is Christmas week, and because I'm a nice guy, I get a present for all of you. I've designed a YouTube subscriber animation package and a social media lower thirds package combined into one big bundle. But that's not all, I'm gonna teach you how to create your own using the macro tool in Fusion as well. Now in the Fusion page, all we see is this media out node, and let's first start by setting the resolution for our project. So let's drag in a background, connect the output of background 1 to the input of media out. Now go to background 1, go to the inspector, and drag down the alpha channel to 0. Now in order to create the title animation, we need a text node, right? So let's grab in a text plus node, connect the output of text 1 to the output of background 1 to create merge 1. And this one's gonna be for our text in the box. And then let's create another text plus node for the lower text. So let's grab this text 2, connect the output of text 2 to merge 1. And now we have two text nodes merged together. But we can't see anything because we haven't typed in anything yet. Let's go to text 1 and type in, say, what's up. Alright. So I'm not gonna mess with the font yet and the color, but I will drag down the size quite a bit. So let's go to text 1, now go to shading, and on shading you wanna select the element number 2 and hit enable. And now what this does, it's by default giving us red outlines which look horrible. And we gotta change that by going to properties and on appearance we click this button right there. And what this does is it creates a background for every single letter. And that's also not what we want to do, but we can extend this horizontally to create a whole background like this. And that's pretty good, but I don't like the red color, so let's just change this to black. And what's the good thing about this is if I were to extend my text right now, you see the box extends with it. If I shorten my text, the box will shorten with it, alright? So that's the great feature about this shading elements. Now this is our first text, and let's now go to our text number 2, add your awesome, right? So then let's drag this down to just around to match the size of the box, because I don't like the spacing in between them. We gotta change the vertical anchor a little bit towards the bottom side, so this comes up just fine. So that is looking pretty good. And now we almost have everything set up perfectly. Now it's time to drag in our Twitter logo. So the right way to import a logo is to use vector files. And to get those vector files, all you gotta do is go to Google, type in Twitter logo SVG, and you can download a bunch there. So let's now go to this upper letter bar, go to Fusion, go to import, and then import SVG. And on there I got my Twitter icons SVG, and I'm gonna select that and hit open. Then I can select the width and the height. Let's just make it a little bit bigger. And now let me hit 2 so we can see the Twitter icon. And as you can see, this is just a basic Twitter icon, but why do we have a group down there? So let's just double click on there. And as you see, there is no image. There is just a merge, two backgrounds, and a path 1. And that's the good thing about vector files, is because if you import a vector file, DaVinci Resolve will take a background to create the color and a path, and basically will mask out the icon for you. The good thing about doing it this way, there is no image, so this can stay forever in Fusion. And that's what we like to have. So let's zoom out, close this, go to media out, hit 2 on our keyboard, zoom back out there. Let's grab the output of this Twitter icon and connect it to the output of merge 2 to create merge 4. And that's merge 4 because we have merge 3 in there. So now we need to adjust the position of our logo. And we do that by selecting the icons group and hit this transform button. And then I wanna just drag it over there. Something like that should be fine. And now we wanna change the logo color from the Twitter logo because we wanna have this nice and clean, and let's change this to a black. So let's double click on the group node, go to background number 2, select the background in the inspector and change the color from blue to black. And now you have a black Twitter logo. Now everything is set and we have our lower thirds right there, and we want to animate this. And instead of animating all those text 1, text 2 and the icon, we want to do this by using a polygon mask. So let's click on this polygon mask button, drag this down to our node editor. Now connect the output of polygon 1 to the blue input of merge 1, to the blue input of merge 2 and the blue input of merge 4. Now this means we have created a mask for every single one of them by using only one node. And that's great. Now go to the polygon 1 tool, go to the inspector and select invert. Now if you see your lower third, just create a nice rectangle around that and select invert again. Now go to frame number 15 and select the keyframe button where it says right click here for shape animation. Just select this keyframe button and then go to the first frame, highlight both handles on the right and drag them over so you can't see any of your tile. And if we play this back now, this will just extend and reveal the lower third that we created. Because this is a 15 frame animation, let's do this for the end as well. So let's go to frame 104, select the keyframe on right click here for shape animation. Now go to frame 119, which is the last frame of a 5 second composition. Select both of the right handles and drag them over to the left. We want to have motion blur, so let's in the inspector go to settings on the polygon 1 node. Select motion blur and leave the quality at 2. All we want to do is go to the spline window because this is a pretty linear movement and we want to have this like ease in and ease out. So let's select polygon 1 polyline and we see that we have those keyframes right there. So select the keyframes on the bottom left, right click, go to ease, in out cubic, and now select the keyframes on the top right. Right click, go to ease, in out cubic, and now we have a nice easing composition. Now let's create our macro. So this is where things get a little bit complicated, but I promise if you follow along and if you play around with the settings, you will get around that. So highlight all nodes except the media out node, right click on one of them, go to macro, create macro, and now this window comes up. First of all, we want to change the name of our macro to Twitter logo. You have all the settings there that you got in the inspector for each node, all right? And chances are you don't need most of the settings, so let's go through them one by one. We made changes to our text one, so let's click on text one, and text one was the text within the box. So basically what we're doing now is select everything that we want to have the control over in the edit page. So in the edit page, I want to change my text, I want to change my font, I want to change the font style, the color, green, blue, alpha, and of course the size and the tracking. Now uncheck text and uncheck text 1. Go to text number 2, uncheck image because we don't need that, and on text number 2 we want to have the same thing. Style text, font, style, color, green, blue, alpha, size and tracking as well. Then close text number 2. We don't have anything on merge number 2. On merge number 1, we don't have anything as well. Background number 1 is just transparent, we don't need that. Transform 1, we don't need that. Merge 4, we also don't need that. But on icons, Twitter, we need the background color, right? And that is on background number 2. And on background number 2, we want to scroll down until you see color, and then we want to change type, color, top green left, blue and alpha. Now close this, go to polygon 1 and go down to where it says common, and then you have the settings for the motion blur because you want to be in full control to change the motion blur on the edit page as well. So let's check motion blur, quality, shutter angle, center bias and sample spread. And once you've made your way all through them, we can then hit close. and it will ask you to save the changes to macro tool 1, and you want to select yes. Now save this file to your desktop as a Twitter logo dot setting and then just click save. We now see this Twitter logo setting right here, and to turn this into a proper functional .drfx file, we're gonna have to do a few steps. First of all, let's create a folder, new folder, and call this folder edit. Then click in there, create another folder, call this titles, and this is important because we are replicating the folder structure from DaVinci Resolve. And if you wanna have a separate folder with your name, as I do have right there on titles as Friedrich or Motion VFX, you can do that by creating another folder and call this whatever. So this will basically be a whatever folder in your titles. And in this whatever folder, you want to drag in this Twitter logo setting file. Now, once you've done that, you can X out and right click on this edit folder, go to zip edit, right? This creates a zip file. On this zip file, you want to right click, go to change name, and don't delete the edit, just delete the zip to .drfx. And when you've done that, just hit enter and it will ask you to change the name from .zip to .drfx. And now you want to select choose .drfx. And now you have a proper .drfx file that you then can install by going back to DaVinci Resolve, open up the Fusion page. When you open up the Fusion page and you have your Node Editor open, you can tap out, go to the Finder, choose this edit .drfx file, drag it onto DaVinci Resolve, let go of it, and now it will ask you to override edit. And that is because I already have a template called edit, so that's why I'm gonna hit cancel. You will just select install because it will ask you to install edit. And once you've done that, you go back to the edit page, and under titles, you have your title right there. That's it, that's how simple it is. Take the time and go through this macro tool one by one to see if you can need any of those settings in your final .drfx file. So guys, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to even more people that might be interested in that specific topic. But with that being said, guys, I wish you all a Merry Christmas. Take a step back, relax a bit, and spend some time with the ones you love. And overall, enjoy your holidays. So yeah, I hope you all have a great time. See you in the next one. Bye.